विचार विमर्श करना चाहिए। धन्यवाद।
एनके प्रेमचंद्रन जी।
मैडम स्पीकर, माय मोशन ऑफ अमेंडमेंट इज ऑल्सो देयर, काइंडली गिव मी सम टाइम बिकॉज आई डिडंट स्पीक एट द टाइम ऑफ मूविंग द मोशन ऑफ अमेंडमेंट। मैडम स्पीकर, द मेन अप्रिहेंशन आई वुड लाइक टू प्लेस इट ऑन रिकॉर्ड प्लेनली, द मेन अप्रिहेंशन रिगार्डिंग दिस बिल इज दैट the over enthusiasm and the interest shown by the government led by BJP supported by Sankariwa in protecting the women Muslim rights, and that is the main reason, and that is there is a cloud of suspicion among the people, especially in the Indian Muslim community, that the government of India is moving in the direction of having a common civil code, and that is the cloud of suspicion existing in our country. So my first submission to the honorable minister, please remove the cloud of suspicion regarding the uniform civil code. Okay. Because none of the Muslim organizations or none of the NGOs or none of the political parties, I feel that Indian National Congress is the first party in India who have supported the Supreme Court judgment is Indian National Congress. So there is no political opposition as far as the triple talaq at one time is concerned. The question is regarding this bill. You kindly come to the bill. This bill is being introduced on the basis of a judgment of 22 August 2017. See, according to me, it is an ill-drafted legislation done in haste and with the ulterior political motive. That is the first contention which I would like to make. I will substantiate. Sir, triple talaq is already declared by the Supreme Court as void and null. And divorced wife or a person against whom the pronouncement of the triple talaq is made, then she is entitled for maintenance or substitution of relevance, and she is entitled for the custody of the children, and also punishment is enunciated. This intention of the bill, I do agree, constitutional morality, dignity of women, gender justice, gender equality, and prevent the discrimination among the women, and to empower men of the women, and all these points we do agree, and we do accept, and we do confirm. And the point is criminalizing a civil wrong. Madam Speaker, the Supreme Court has already struck down the triple talaq, declared it as void and null. That has become the law of the land. According to Article 141 of the Constitution, it has become the law of the land. Then the question arises, what is the need of further legislation? That is the number one question. Madam, the flaws in the bill, I am directly coming to the flaws in the bill. The number one flaw, one of the fundamental maxims of criminal jurisprudence is, I quote, madam, nullum crimen sine injuria, unquote. Madam, that means no person shall be punished for an act that does not prove to be significantly harmful to anyone. Madam, kindly see, talaq-e-bidat pronounced that has been declared as void in August 22, does not, and subsequent to that, it does not in any manner harms or violate the right of the wife unless the husband refuses to perform his conjugal duties or forces to leave the wife from his house on the basis of the pronouncement of the triple talaq. So that criminal jurisprudence basic fundamental principle is being violated in this case, because when the talaq is become null and void, what is the consequential act on it comes? That is the second question which I would like to make. Even if the government is so concerned about the liberty and the freedom and the rights of the unprivileged Muslim women in the country, there is 498A is there? Indian Penal Code 498 is there. Protection of women from the Domestic Violence Act of 2005 is there. Very well, we can invoke. Even if you want to make an amendment and make it clear, definitely you can make amendments in the Domestic Violence Act, even amendment in the Indian Penal Code. But here in this case, this is an unnecessary attempt to convert a civil wrong into a criminal act with ulterior political motives, and it is, madam, counterproductive. That is another submission. Sir, madam, coming to that. Then further, it is against the criminal jurisprudence on the following three grounds also. Number one, the harsh punishment of 3 years imprisonment defies or against the doctrine of proportionality. Number two, 3 years imprisonment to husband further penalizing the poor woman because she is further aggrieved because her husband is in jail. And number three, it may aggravate the already acute insecurity and alienation of Indian Muslim community in the mainstream. And madam, the last point which I would like to make is the provisions of the bill is totally contradictory. I would like to seek the clarification from the Honorable Minister. Section 3 is there. Yes, according to Section 3, it is null and void. According to Section 4, criminal punishment is being made for 3 years. See, how then Section 4 and 5 will become applicable? Because when the talaq is already declared void, the marriage is subsisting. When the marriage is subsisting, why the husband can be forced to give the subsistence allowance? In the opening speaker, already Susmitasan has already said, what is the definition for the subsistence allowance? Is there any definition for the subsistence allowance? And even if the argument of the government is accepted by us, suppose we are accepting the argument by the government,
yes.
Even then, yes, madam, even then my point is, how, madam, even then my point is, a jailed person can, how can he maintain and give subsistence allowance to have his wife? He is in jail, he will be getting food, he will be getting clothes, he will be getting shelter. Unfortunately, the women will be further suffering. So, madam, that question to be answered. And the final point, retrospective effect. See, I want a specific clarification. So many amendments I have given. See, when this class 5 and 6, when it becomes operative. See, if you are operating with retrospective effects, according to this act, madam, kindly see, we are drafting a legislation. According to clause 5 and clause 6 of this bill, if this is bad as a law, then all the divorces or triple talaq made prior to the commencement of the act will be applicable. That means a flooding of petitions will come into the courts. No doubt about it. Because the commencement of the act, because the talaq will come into existence only prior to the commencement of the act, only prior to the commencement of the passing of the notification of this act. Subsequent to that, there is no talaq. Because talaq is null and void ab initio at the first place. So, madam, I'm concluding. So, madam, my suggestion and my submission is, so, madam, the last one, no, I'm not. So, my submission is, there is lot of doubt of suspicion. So, my point is, I have moved an amendment motion to the motion for considering and passing the bill. This bill may be given to the public for eliciting the public opinion. None of the Muslim organizations have supported this bill. Kindly see. They have to be consulted. Kindly have a consultation. Come with a consensus. Then draft the bill, and we will unanimously pass the bill without any difficulty. That is the point which I would like to make. So kindly give it for public opinion. Wider consultation be made so that we can have a fruitful bill in this house. With these words, I conclude. Thank you very much, madam.
Madam Speaker.